messed up the bottles, didn't they? So when would you use Calmag?
I'd particularly use it when I was using Coco.
Okay.
Coco fibre holds on to calcium, it retains it. So you tend to see a lot of deficiencies occurring in Coco fibre. So this would be something I would use in that. Now, some of our favourite plants are quite heavy feeders with calcium. And calcium is a very immobile element, meaning that it doesn't easily get taken up. And it's been one of the real banes of my life. It precipitates out. It attaches itself to sulfates, it attaches itself to phosphates.
So you're saying even if you supply calcium, it still might not be used?
Correct. So it's making sure it's in a form that the plant can take up as well.
Ah.
So foliar feeding with this is a better way of actually doing it. Spraying on the underneath of the leaves so that it can be taken up by the stomata. Making sure that you're keeping that leaf wet for a period of time as well. But as I say, it's quite immobile, calcium. And magnesium's another as well, which you usually see the deficiencies occurring simultaneously. Another element as well that we've put into there is iron, which helps with the greening up of the plant as well. So we've done a kind of a whole mixture of different elements in there in order to combat these deficiencies that are quite commonly seen with cocoa fibre.
Awesome.